Mike and Jennifer are really old friends of mine. I actually designed their kitchen 10 years ago, almost 11. So to get a text from Mike and say, help us design our dream home, was a great text to get because I really like them. They're just a good, fun couple. And if I'm getting back in the client game, I want to know and love them. And I do. The house that they bought is a one-story, small little bungalow. It's on the outskirts of Chicago, where a lot of the city workers are, firefighters, cops, people in the medical field. That's what Mike does. He's a firefighter. He's been doing it the whole time I've known him.
The house is awesome, tons of potential, but it needs so much work.
The bank has allotted us $375,000 from start to finish.
Okay.
Hoping to be on the lower end of the 300.
What's your lower end?
325.
So you'd like to keep it at 325, but you are approved for 375 with the bank loan.
That's right.
Got it.
Anything we can save.
I want you to think big, and then I want to see what I can actually give you. This house needs so much work. Mike and Jen's $375,000 budget is really going fast, and luckily Mike's got a big crew he can put to work.
Get inside and go do something. I brought over 12 of my good buddies from the firehouse.
Everything but now.
We're pulling ceiling, pulling down walls.
I'm gonna start knocking some of this down from up here.
We wanted to build something that was our own, so to have a little bit of my sweat involved in the whole thing makes it a little bit more satisfying. The last time we were here, everything was progressing. And then everything came to a halt. There's a disagreement with the contractor on what still needs to be done and what doesn't need to be done. So I brought in a good friend of mine just to walk through what needs to be corrected, be finished. We're at a standstill right now. There hasn't been work done in a little bit. And there was a discrepancy about framing out that south side wall there.
Should be framed out, you know, like the rest of these.
Okay.
So you can't get your electrical in here. We can't insulate it. We don't have room for our boxes, for our pipe to get electrical in here.
Right. I've known Dave 5-6 years now. We are at the same firehouse together. He's a GC, so he knows this stuff a lot better than I do.
Let's see, what do we got here? Primary bath. Plumbing's gonna have to be moved. The shower valves are almost in the middle of the shower door. They're not gonna work there, that's for sure.
Okay.
I feel for you, buddy.
Thanks, pal.
I really do.
To not even mince words, I'm pissed off. We could be doing finishes probably right now if people were on the ball. So frustrated is the understatement of the year. I'm flat out pissed off.
Hey.
Hey.
What's going on, bud?
Well, I don't know. I'm making the call that I kind of dreaded having to make to you, but.
What?
Yeah, it's not anything malicious, but I think we're going to have to move on from the current contractor.
What are you talking about? You're so far in.
I know, but he's behind, and the communication's awful. There are definitely some issues with what's going on with the build. Even the subs he brought in were no good. It's just been one thing after the other. Ever since I've got new eyes on it, I had my friend who's a general contractor who quoted me in the beginning.
And he's also your friend, so be careful.
Exactly.
About
exactly.
That.
Okay.
Exactly. Is that who you're going with?
I have to. He is. Ever since I sat down with him, the ball has been rolling really well right away.
Okay, listen. You're not at a place where you can actually just start setting up interviews. You got to do it. You got to do what you got to do. What does this do to the overall schedule?
I don't know, but it is being delayed. But yeah. I personally think it'll get finished quicker than it would have with the last guy.
This is your house. This is your money. This is your decision. This is not something to mess around with. So
yeah, it would have never gotten done if I had stayed down this path.
All right, man.
Okay.
Okay. All right. I'll talk to you.
Okay,
goodbye. You got to do what you got to do. And I'm sure Jennifer's freaking out. But all we care about is getting them into their house. So Mike decided to move forward with Dave as his new GC, and finally, the overhaul project's moving again. They've reframed the walls, fixed the stairs, they moved the electrical and plumbing to all the correct spots, and now they're starting drywall. Going to overhaul today. So I'm gonna meet his new GC, Dave. I've heard good things about him. I just want to make sure that we really are on track. You know, it's one thing to talk to Mike, but it's one thing to hear it straight from the horse's mouth. So I want to go talk to the horse. Hello. Nice to finally meet you.
Dave.
Dave, heard so much about you.
Hopefully it was good.
Dave saves the day.
Yeah, sometimes.
That's what Mike thinks. Is everything kind of fixed at this point?
I think so. I think we're in good shape.
Okay.
The drywall's going up, so yeah. I think we're in
good
shape.
It feels really good in here. You've moved a lot. This looks really good.
Hopefully by the mid next week, we should be done taping, and then I want to start doing flooring and getting that. That's what I'm shooting for.
When you just said flooring, you made me very happy.
Yeah, well.
Very happy. You're running all the planks this way.
Yes, we're running all the planks this way. I think as of right now, we're in good shape.
Cool. Good meeting
you. It was nice meeting you.
This is a huge tipping point. He says, we're getting ready to install flooring. That's music to my ears. I mean, flooring means you're getting really close. Look, I mean, it's kind of showing off now. It looks so good.
Thank God.
I'm obsessed. It's amazing. I love the grid window. I love that storefront look. You got a lot of textures, but they all work together and the colors blend. The lighting's key. And I know there were a lot of hurdles, but this is yours now.
This is a legit dream come
true. Inside of your dream home?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Please.
Okay, come on.
Absolutely insane.
Oh my God.
Wow, this is amazing.
Oh my God, I want to bawl my eyes out. I know, I know. This is your home?
This is our house.
The stairs. It looks like a magazine.
I know, right?
We were talking always from the beginning. It was this modern farmhouse feel, and it's just sexy. This is the family room, right? We played around with this floor plan for so long. Now it just feels massive. Look at this. I mean, to find this is $300. Look what Ari was able to do with it to come in, match everything.
Incredible.
Just have
it's really sharp.
It's sharp.
It's really sharp.
Yeah. Seriously, look at this kitchen, please.
Look at that.
Everything.
How do you not
fall
in love with this? You will absolutely love working in this kitchen because it functions perfectly. Look how big your island is. A sea of cabinets. This hood is out of control.
That is really awesome.
That's really awesome. And it's the combo of the wood and the beautiful patinaed copper tying back in, and it's yours.
I can't believe in this.
This is your kitchen. This is a real show-off kitchen, too.
We did it.
Yeah.
And stayed married through the process.
Okay.
This is incredible.
That's awesome.
Oh, my God. Look how big the room feels.
You were right.
This is spacious.
Yes.
Getting in and out of bed. I mean, those nightstands are small. You could get even bigger ones. The light, though, that comes in.
Incredible.
I know. And then who has a closet like this? Come here.
Oh.
Get in there.
Wow.
Okay.
Come to mama.
Look how big it is. Look at this. You have so many damn drawers.
I know.
It's perfect.
This is our house.
Yeah.
Our kids are still little, so all of their memories are going to be in this house. Incredible. I knew the color of the cabinets. I knew the copper. I knew the light fixture. I knew. But seeing it all together is beyond my wildest dreams.
And you can now envision life here, and your kids here, and your friends here, and your family, and your holidays.
This is 100% our dream house.
I love that.
100%.
I love that.